So here we have an ordinary empty paper towel roll and air compressor hose that blows. And here's an interesting trick, it can suck. Now what makes that go? It's the Venturi effect. So what makes this suction happen? So imagine we have a lot of air coming out through here and it's pressurized, so it's coming out at high speed. And as soon as it comes out of this pipe, it starts mixing with the air in here. So by turbulent mixture, we get basically a mixture of the air that's coming out of here and the air that's already in the tube. Now imagine the air is coming out here at, say, 100 meters per second, and it's mixing with four times as much air that's already in the tube. Now by conservation of momentum, that momentum from the 100 meters per second here spread over five times as much air is now 20 meters per second. So we have essentially five times as much air moving out here at 20 meters per second. That, of course, means we need to replace this air, and that's what creates suction in here. By basically replacing the air that's been mixed and shot out this end, and so we get suction coming in this end. The suction is greatly enhanced by the tube, but it exists even without the tube. So if I now put my air compressor nozzle right here, and I blow, notice how we actually even sucked up sawdust from behind the end of the nozzle and all around. Another cool way to demonstrate this principle is to submerge a jet of water in a bucket of muddy water. Notice how the jet is much wider and picks up a lot of the muddy water. Also see how the water level in the bucket is dropping. Pretty much every gas burning appliance uses the Venturi effect to pre-mix the gas with the air. So on my furnace we have the gas coming in here and we've got three nozzles here that jet the natural gas into here, which sucks a lot of air into here, and that pre-mixes the gas to burn inside the burners. Spray guns like this also rely on the Venturi effect to mix the liquid, but I've actually built a very primitive sort of spray gun just by taping a bendy straw to the nozzle. So the nozzle's here, and here it's going to pull it off. The way this crude spray gun works is we have the compressed air coming out of the nozzle here, and it immediately starts to spread out and turbulently mix with the air around it, which, just like in the tube, ends up with a lot more air that is moving than before, which means we have air being pulled into this all around, and this straw being right here, that creates negative pressure, and that pulls the water up, pulls it into the stream, and then just the high speed of the air is enough to break the surface tension and to just turn it into tiny little droplets in the air. Spraying is even more fun if you're using a flammable liquid.